Hey everybody, it's John with Freshwater Systems. In today's video, we're going to walk you through the steps to do a filter change and maintenance on a NeoPure Pro 4 Series reverse osmosis system. You're going to need a pair of sanitary gloves, some towels, a sanitizing kit, and some needle nose pliers, a housing wrench, a tire gauge, and a small pan and a bottle brush. To start with, turn off the water supply at the feed adapter valve. The blue handle should be perpendicular to the tubing. Next, open the faucet and drain the tank, preferably into a jug that you can put in the fridge and save, or down the drain if that's not necessary, but take all the water out of the tank and totally depressurize the system. If you haven't left yourself enough slack, go ahead and disconnect tubing. Be careful when you remove the housing, as they'll be full of water. And having a pan to set the unit in is always convenient to keep water spill down to a minimum. Once the housings are out, dump out the water and discard the cartridge. And with warm soapy water and a bottle brush, give the inside of those housings a clean. Remove the wrapping from the new cartridges and drop them in the housings. Then simply reattach the housings to the manifold. Housings should go on hand tight, but a little extra turn with a wrench is okay. Just be careful not to over-tighten, as that could damage the O-ring. Now, if it's time for the membrane replacement, go to the housing, the membrane housing, and disconnect the tube that feeds it up on the top by the cap. Press in the collet on the fitting as you pull the tube from it. Once the tube is disconnected, move the mineral filter out of the way, and then unscrew the cap on the membrane housing. And this is where our needle nose pliers come in to pull the membrane free of the housing. Get your bottle brush out again and clean the inside of the housing. The new membrane goes in and the O-ring's on the bottom. And the way you know that you got it in there is the membrane will slide all the way in. Then replace the cap and reconnect the tubing. All right, now let's put some sanitizer in the tank. It's always a good idea to sanitize the tank periodically. You don't necessarily have to sanitize every time you change your pre and post filter, but it's a great idea to sanitize at least at membrane change. And to do that, if you have the sanitization kit with these quick connects, it makes it really easy. Inject your sanitizer into the tube on the tank and then plug in the feed line so that now we can direct fill the tank full of sanitizer. Turn on the valve at the angle stop adapter and fill the tank. And by doing so, the sanitizer that we injected in the fitting will also go into the tank. The sanitizer only needs a minute to do its job. If it's been a long time, let it sit for 5 or 10 minutes. Now it's time to reconnect our tube. So turn the tank valve off. Make sure that your supply tube is turned off and reconnect the feed to its mate and the tank line to its mate. Now that we've done this, we can flush all of the sanitizer out of the tank. So lift the faucet handle and let the tank empty. The water will flow through the post filter to the faucet. So we really don't need to do anything else. Once that's done, then we're going to turn the water off and put our post filter in. Okay, now let's replace the remineralization cartridge. Each end of the remineralization cartridge is a quick connect style fitting, and there are stem elbows that go into each end. You may need a little tool to help you remove the fitting from the end of the cartridge. Be sure and put it in the flow direction and there is an arrow on the label, and in this particular setting it flows from left to right. There are plugs in the fittings in the new cartridge. Be sure and remove them. And the tubes reconnect simply by pressing them into the fitting and make sure they go in all the way. All right, we've got new cartridges in our system. Be sure and reconnect any tubing that you disconnected to do the service. Then slowly turn the feed supply back on so that the system slowly pressurizes and check for leaks. Now the system will pressurize, so in a couple of minutes, check for leaks. Make sure your housings aren't leaking or any of the fittings that you disconnected and put back together. Allow the system to fill the tank and then dump that to the drain. Do this two more times and your system should be good to go. The filter replacement interval is usually 6 to 12 months, and that's going to be determined about how much you use the system. If you have a large family and you're using a lot of water, plan on changing the pre, the post, and the mineral cartridge every 6 months. If it's just you and a spouse, small family, don't use it much, then 12 months should be an adequate changeout time, again for the pre, the post, and the mineral cartridge. Membrane life is really determined much by the amount of minerals that are in the water that feeds the system. For example, if you have hard water, you can plan on replacing that membrane about every 24 months. If you have soft water or not a lot of minerals in the water, you might be able to get 3 to 5 or even longer years on your membrane. Best way to check membrane life is with a TDS meter. That's a little handheld device that checks the amount of minerals that are in the water, and you compare what's feeding the system to what's coming out, and you want to see about 90% less coming out than's going in. When it starts to show 70%, maybe 75, then it's time to change the membrane. Well, that's all I've got. Please call us if you have any questions. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and for all your replacement cartridge needs, check us out at freshwatersystems.com.